bruised for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. Jesus knew why he was sent to earth by God. He was to die on the cross to save us from our own deaths as a result of our sins. Jesus told everyone around that he would one day die and come to life 3 days later, but no one understood what he said. The week before Jesus was crucified, he knew it was the last week before he would suffer, but no one else knew what was about to happen to him. Several days later, before Jesus would be arrested and later crucified, he entered Jerusalem. His disciples and people from the city were so happy, they waved palm branches at Jesus and put their cloaks and branches onto the ground for him to walk on. They greeted him like you would a king. He was the King of Kings, and his disciples believed in him and knew he was God. But less than a week later, the same city would turn on Jesus and shout for him to be crucified. The mob of people yelled for Barabbas, a horrible criminal, to be released, and for Jesus, the only perfect person ever to live, to be tortured and killed in a horrible way. Jesus, like a perfect lamb, had to be crucified so we could believe in him and escape the punishment of our death for our sins. But how sad to be the people that shouted and yelled and convinced Pilate to release Barabbas and kill the Son of God. It is easy to be like Pilate and listen to a huge group of people and do what they say, even when what the group says is not right or really, really bad. We need to put our faith in Jesus and not the people around us. When the people greeted Jesus like a king, they were listening to truth and following Jesus. When the people shouted for Jesus to be crucified, they were being used to kill the Son of God. And even though Jesus needed to die, it was horrible to shout for him to be crucified. Don't do what everybody else does. Don't listen to the crowd just because they shout the loudest. Listen to the still small voice of Jesus and let him be your compass.